do, because Stormbringer and Clockwork is an amazing combo, I think.
Yeah, but just the range of initiation and the map control that you can have against the enemy team, it's terrifying to play against. You can't have wards everywhere, and whenever there's a lapse in vision, the Stormspire clock could jump on you. If you ever get behind against that combination, I think it is very potent. Undying will be banned out by Newbie Young, and well, let's see what they're going to go ahead and pick up. It's going to be a Lina. We don't know for sure yet if this is a Lina support or Lina mid. I think both of their ways have their merits. Combined with the Rubick, it has reliable setup for the Light Strike raid, and support Lina could work here, but I think for now we should probably assume it's going to the mid lane.
Yeah, I'm gonna assume it's Millen. It's pretty good against Gyro. He's kind of squishy for quite some time, and having a front Lina can really punish that. And we've seen both today, though, both support Lina
Yeah,
and a
good enough.
mid Lina, and Energy Pacemaker go with the Dragonite that they've done before. I think Olshiken plays a pretty good Dragonite.
Yeah, one of his comfort zone heroes, definitely. It's going to struggle a little bit in lane against Zelina, but still, he should be able to get his farm just by spamming out his Breathe Fire. And the aggressive rotations that Old Chicken makes on his DK are peculiar, but they seem to work out for them. They catch the enemy team off guard. Phantom Lancer will be the pickup for Newbie Young, even though there's a Gyrocopter enemy side who's really good against PL when it comes to dealing with his illusions and finding the real PL so you can focus him down. Phantom Lancer's still a really good pick. He has a natural way to get rid of track, and there's no solid initiation to get on the Phantom Lancer before he's able to start the fight and stop him from spreading his cancer minions.
Yeah, Phantom Lancer and Gyrocopter has a pretty interesting relationship when they face each other. Gyrocopter is a counter to Phantom Lancer. Also, Dragonite is pretty good against Phantom Lancer because of the
Sucker!
splash. But if the game goes too late, Phantom Lancer tends to become too much, even if Gyro goes for something like Divine. The illusions, just there's too many of them, and Gyrocopter can't deal with it in the end. But it's very good in early and mid game. You just have to get an advantage so Phantom Lancer doesn't get too much.
Yeah, it definitely is the case. Disruptor is going to help out Energy Pacemaker in dealing with this PL, gives them the Static Storm, which is almost mandatory at this point, as they don't have reliable ways to lock him down. The Bounty Hunter makes it a lot harder to draft around that, and I'm not sure one hero in the offlane would be the appropriate lockdown that they need for a PL. I think it's a good pick.
Yeah. Disruptor pick, it's a bit weird, I think. It doesn't really fit that well. It's not particularly good against Clockwork. It's okay against Clockwork, but it's not good either. And it's not like a counter to Phantom Lancer either. It's a bit of a weird pick, but it's a pretty reliable hero still.
In
He's.
general, I think Disruptor is just good here. Like, it's
Yeah.
not amazing, but he still does his job. Glimpse is great utility to have if you're able to play aggressive with the Bounty Hunter. They'll want to be doing that. And yeah, Static Storm is good against PL. It's not a counter, of course, and it's good against the Clockwork. I think there's just enough tally marks in the good side that will counteract the Disruptor's weaknesses.
Yeah, now it's the question, is it Earthshaker or is it not Earthshaker? Is Lina gonna be mid or is it not gonna be mid? That's pretty much what's gonna be here. I was a bit surprised. I thought an Energy Pacemaker would pick up the Earthshaker as their fourth, even though they already had Bounty and it would be a bit melee heavy, but that's not a big problem. It's not like you are gonna clump up with those heroes.
Yeah, and a lot of the time you're picking up safe laners that can be left alone fairly comfortably, especially against a Clockwork. Most safe lane heroes can do fairly well, at the very least, not die to the clock.
Yeah, thinking a lot here. It's their last pick, so they have time. I think they should put Lina mid. She does very well against Dragonite, and Bounty is a bit scary because you're pretty squishy on Lina, but I think you can deal with it. You are on Radiant side. It's a bit easier, and I think they should go for Earthshaker here. It seems like a really good pick for them.
Earthshaker in general is just always good. He's not banned out, and yeah, I think that's probably going to be what they settle on. But since they've been thinking about it for so long, I might be a little bit disappointed if it's an Earthshaker. If you're going to be taking this much time to consider it, I'm hoping for something a little bit more
Oh.
off the wall. It's a Bloodseeker. Okay, that probably means it's a support Lina, but if they feel it's appropriate, they could go for a jungling Bloodseeker, but already with a Bounty Hunter on the enemy side, I think that's way too greedy. Safe lane farming, or wait, how will they on this? Mid Phantom Lancer or mid Bloodseeker, what do you think?
Not sure. I think it's gonna be mid Bloodseeker. I don't know actually. It's kind of weird. I feel like they could put Bloodseeker safe lane because then the potential Darkseer pick becomes a bit worse for Energy Pacemakers, which I think could be a reason why they picked the Bloodseeker.
Yeah. It might not dissuade them from going for the Darkseer, however, it still combos really nicely with the Disruptor and the Gyrocopter. Even though Darkseer can't force out the Bloodseeker in lane, he still should be able to farm reasonably well, as long as the Rubick and Lina aren't on top of him all of the time, which they very well might. Leaving the Phantomancer 1v1 against the Dragonite is a fine lane for Phantomancer.
Yeah, Phantomancer does surprisingly well in mid. He's with a bottle, he can spam Spirit Lance quite a lot, and he can harass out quite a lot of mid laners. He does a lot better than some people think. And it's a Pacemaker, they're taking a long time. I think they have a few options, which would be Spirit Breaker and Darkseer, mainly, I think. Not sure what else they are thinking of. It's pretty. They have. I think they could pull something weird out as well to try and deal with Phantomlands and Bloodseeker, but I don't know. The Earthshaker is still there as an offlane Earthshaker.
Yeah, I think Earthshaker is probably the safest choice, as Z usually is, but again, they're going to be taking their time with this last pick. Nothing immediately comes to mind that's better than the Shaker, I don't think. It is a Shaker into Clockwork, so that's a little bit awkward for the Shaker if he gets isolated, but even though that counter is there, it doesn't stop you from going for it, but that's a greedy pick. Energy Pacemaker, how do they get these lanes to work out in their favor? The Lina and the Rubick aren't really necessary for Nubian to still have okay lanes, and everywhere the Rubick and Lina go, there is going to be killing potential with these Energy Pacemaker heroes. The Gyrocopter, Dragonite, and Ember Spirit all kind of need to be babysat a little bit. Dragonite the least of the three, but even so, I think that's way too greedy for Energy Pacemaker. This is going to be a difficult game, I want to say.
Is this a support gyro and offlane bounty for EP?
It looks like it. Lei is playing on the gyrocopter, and traditionally he has been playing on the support gyro. It's not something we've seen for quite a while, but it is a possibility. Interesting that they'd opt for
It has to be like
those
that, yeah.
heroes. Yeah, it does. Old Chicken's going to be playing on the Dragonite. Bounty Hunter's going to be going offlane by Xiaotu Lei. The Disruptor will be handled by 5400, and that rounds out the lineup for the Energy Pacemaker side. For Nubie Young, they're on the Radiant side of the map with Aiwi playing on the Clockwork. Mid lane, Bloodseeker by SCC, and their safe lane will be Lina by Melody Lovers. Piao on the Rubick, and Phantomlancer handled by SS. They'll spot out the bounty, drops a sentry to block out that camp, and it looks like he should be able to make himself safe here. He has boots first, and Bounty Hunter is a very fast hero. Light Trick Rate is going to miss, and with it, their hopes of killing him off are completely gone.
Don't forget overlay. I think
Oh,
the chat is
apologies.
complaining.
Oh, sorry about that, guys. Very awkward, but with a dust on the Bounty Hunter, at least the overlay won't cover up First Blood. He's pulled back into the Light Strike Array with the silence from the Bloodseeker. That's going to be a kill. Yeah, big whoops there. Sorry for that. The beginning of this game is going to be tainted by terrible boxes. Both bounty runes are going to be picked up. Nubie Young will get the bounty rune up in bottom lane, and the top bounty rune will be secured by Old Chicken.
Yeah. Not the greatest start from offlane bounty. If you give away first blood like that, the enemy can buy more sentries and ward. I mean, dust, and it becomes twice as hard. It's one of the heroes that you really don't want to give away gold support because they can punish you a lot easier than other offlaners.
Yeah, with the dust already picked up and with the sentry on the Lina, the Bounty Hunter really isn't going to be laning as much as he is just hiding in the trees and trying to keep himself safe. The mid lane matchup, it's not one we see very often. It's Bloodseeker versus Dragonite, fairly evenly, I want to say. Bloodseeker isn't going to be spammed out by the Dragonite's Breathe Fire, and neither of them can really kill each other pre-6, and even once level 6 comes out, as long as DK has a TP, he should be fine.
Yeah, both heroes sustain pretty well, so it's probably gonna be very even. Both are probably gonna free farm completely. So it's gonna be kind of offlaner versus offlaner who decides who gets the early advantage, and already a death on bounty is gonna be favorable for Clockwork. But he's not getting a lot right now.
He's trading blows with the Disruptor at the moment. Aiwi has a reasonable amount of regen, but he's going to be almost out of it. Looks like Clockwork's going to be going for the bottle, however, getting it pretty quickly. That'll help him sustain this lane. He's found himself level 2. On the same token, Bounty Hunter's gotten about the same. This laning stage looks fairly even. I don't think there's really a big advantage for either team.
Yeah, Bounty found a great spot to hide and get experience, actually. It's pretty hard to find him as well, because he could be in this anywhere. So that's a good play from him. And rune spawning, I don't think there's going to be any fights for the runes. Unless Clockwork gets there too late.
Gyrocopter's there with the Rocket Barrage. He'll bounce back the gyro, pick up the double damage rune, and eat through his cogs. There is Kinetic Field blocking in place with the Rocket Barrage damage. Ivy's going to be dropped fairly low. And Dragon Knight is coming in, but with not enough mana for a Breathe Fire. Looks like Ivy's going to get away with stealing that rune. That's a pretty big deal. Rocket Barrage will continue to go, but really, oh, cogs coming through. Do they actually kill the Clockwork here? One auto attack is all that they need, and they'll secure it, but the Gyrocopter is going to die in return to the Bloodseeker, and 5400 also not looking too comfortable with no mana at all. The Bloodseeker could, in theory, just kill him off, especially since he's blocked in inside the trees by those creeps. This is a sad death for 5400. He'll eat through one of the trees with a Tango, but he's going down one way or another.
Yeah. Bounty bottom lane goes down at the same time. Got caught. That was an expensive dive. I think Clockwork could even have turned and solo killed the Gyro was the one who died the first, but in the end, I think it works out. Bloodseeker gets both kills there. Also, Clockwork gets the experience here because the supports had to run away unless it dies.
I think Iwi is going to be safe here since there is no Gyrocopter, but the Flame Guard damage is coming through, and Iwi's late on getting the cogs. He doesn't have the cooldown available, but with Battery Assault turns around on the fan pretty heftily. He's going to drop those cogs, bounces back the Gyrocopter, but the Clockwork's dropping too low. He tries to find himself a path to freedom, but 5400 is taking a creep wave. The Disruptor dies, and they actually don't kill the clock. My goodness, that's a big miss. That was a double creep wave hitting that Disruptor. He ends up going down just to that.
Yeah, Clockwork banked on the massive creep wave. He was like, okay, I can't get out of here. I have to man fight. And it was the perfect decision, and he gets a kill from it. He doesn't even die.
That's a huge deal. The Clockwork's almost going to be at level 4. And compare him to the Bounty Hunter. Bounty Hunter's getting about the same amount of experience, but he's also died twice, giving a lot of space to the safe lane. Fortunately for the Bounty Hunter, the Dust is going to miss, so Xiao Tulei is going to survive a little while longer, but Energy Pacemaker this early game, although the CS is fairly even across the board, it's a slight edge for DBYoung, and those 5 kills really start to add up.
Yeah. 3 people mid, but they're not gonna go for the Bloodseeker. Disruptor still doesn't have a leveling Grim, so he can't really catch someone off guard.
Even if he had 1 point in Glimpse, I think the Bloodseeker is too fast to get caught by level 1 Glimpse.
Yeah. Dragonite is not 6, so he can't just pop ultimate and stun yet. Pretty even, but Bond is wasting a lot of time here in mid. They kinda need the kill.
They'll try for it, and with the Breathe Fire, looks like they'll catch SCC inside the Kinetic Field. He will go down. They invest a lot of time, but it's worth it since they stop the Bloodseeker from snowballing. It's a big deal that Dragonite picks up the kill.
Yeah, also a good kill. Bounty really needed that. He wasted a lot of time for that, and it paid off. But Clockwork's still getting quite a lot in his lane. The supports are not really punishing him after the triple death.
Oh, TP in the mid lane by the Bloodseeker. He's just going to get right back into this lane. He drops Silence on the old chicken. The amp as well. It will clip him, and it does a little bit of harass to the DK, but his bottle's flying out in the courier, so that harass isn't going to stick.
Nope. Bloodseeker, he's pretty aggressive still. He died recently and he's still like manning up here. I'm surprised he's being this cocky.
Especially since they don't have vision over the supports. Lay and 5400 haven't been spotted for a long time by this
OTP.
Radiant Ward. We'll look for mid lane. The Lightstrike Array connects on the old chicken. The damage there from the Bloodseeker will connect, and with the silence proccing, Bloodseeker will secure a kill again on the Dragonite. This time it's the Radiant supports to rotate. It works wonderfully for them. Up in top lane, what are they getting in trade? They get a glimpse back onto Iwi. The Clockwork will go down. The Ember Spirit picking up the last hit.
Good kill there.
And a double kill for the Bloodseeker as he picks up the Bounty Hunter. I had no idea how that Bounty Hunter died. There was a Radiant Sentry in mid, and I assume he just got caught out of position. Right-click down. Invis Rune picked up by the Ember Spirit. He is going to bottle dump.
And I'm also going for Midas.
He has been left alone in this bottom lane. I think Midas is a reasonable pickup given the game state. Since it's a support Gyrocopter, taking this late for DBYoung is a reasonable course of action. But
mid lane.
And they'll get the jump. TP attempt by Bloodseeker is not going to succeed. He'll be brought down. A lot of damage from the Flame Guard as well as the Breathe Fire.
Yeah, it's the worst feeling when you TP out, try to make a clutch play, and then you die. You lose a lot more than you could have if you just died and not spent the TP. But I think Phantom Lance is kind of trusting Bloodseeker and Cloakwork here to put a lot of pressure on the enemy team, and he wants to get to late game as soon as possible so he can deal with Garu and DK.
And I think that trust isn't without warrant. The Clockwork's almost sitting on his level 6 mark, and once he finds that, he can very easily kill off the Bounty Hunter and the Gyrocopter. Gyrocopter's only level 4, and Lee's not getting much farm to back that up, and oh, mid lane, rotation again. Bottles galore as everybody's going to throw them onto the heroes coming in. They smoke up with the Ember Spirit and Disruptor. An interesting smoke, but it might just work out onto this clock if he sticks around in lane. They have nice vision to spot out any rotations. The missile, level 2, will fly into Aiwi. The Ember Spirit and the Disruptor coming from the sidelines, jumping forward with the Remnant. They'll get the chains, and this should be a kill onto the clock. There are no creeps for him to hookshot away towards, even if he wanted to. He'll turn for the flare, just a little bit of damage before he dies.
A bit sad. Clockwork, he was sensing there was something on, but he was a bit too late with the Ember Spirit just jumping in with Fire Remnant. But a lot of rotations, actually. 4 people in enemy jungle.
Bottom lane, Bounty Hunter caught up by the Rubick and Phantom Lancer. Going to be an easy kill for newbie Young. This Bounty Hunter is not finding any space at all. He's getting close to level 6, but he's died 4 times this game.
Yeah, they only were 2 heroes dead for that bounty kill, while Energy Pacemakers kind of committed 3 and also 1 hero stacking jungle, and so they committed quite a lot while Newber just farming overall. I hope they make value out of these stacks, otherwise they're gonna let Newbie get ahead because of the Midas.
It's going to be difficult. There is a haste rune on Old Chicken, but the Dragonite himself can't get kills. It would require more rotations for them to pull that through. 8-5, Newbie Young, even though they are farming quite a lot across the map, they're also getting kills for themselves. The state of the game is looking really good for the Newbie Young side.
Yeah, this Bounty is so poor. He's offlaner, and he's lowest net worth in the game right now, while Clockwork is position 5. So the difference in offlaner is really showing right now.
Rotation in from Old Chicken. They'll give Bounty Hunter a little bit of extra space, and he will get his level 6 very shortly, so that helps, but the DK is also not farming during this time. If they don't get the kill on the Clockwork soon, this is not looking good for Energy Pacemaker. They're falling behind quite heavily, behind the Bloodseeker and Phantom Lance, so they're gonna pop the DK for him and just change this into a straight push onto the tower.
Yeah, Newbie are doing the same though, and Bloodseeker is getting quite a lot for mid. He might go for Midas as well, and it looks like he did. Yeah, so double Midas, and they're really looking for late game here.
For sure. With those Midases running, the pressure's on Energy Pacemaker to set up kills, but the Bounty Hunter, since he has had such a poor time, it's going to be difficult for them. They don't have a clean way to initiate fights, like the Clockwork hookshot in. Nothing really that compares, or even gets close to comparing to that.
Yeah, Energy Pacemaker looks like they will get 2 towers. No, they won't go for the mid tower. I think Dragonite could have used some auto attacks on the tower and brought it down, but he's kind of scared of the rupture as well. But they kind of need to put more pressure with the double Midas running on the Newbie Young. They can't afford to let it go unpunished.
And after that Midas, Phantom Lance is up to almost 2,000 gold. Doesn't look like he's going to go for Boots of Travel since he actually buys a TP, but still, Phantom Lancer is going to be accelerating his farm in quite a big way. Rubick gets his hands onto the Ember Spirit ultimate. That's a really cool spell to see on Rubick. We saw it yesterday, and you can set up a lot with that.
Yeah, already have Arcanes as well, so you can actually sustain using them, which is pretty important. If you only have Boots, you can use like 1 or 2, then you're out of mana to get rid of your normal spells. But this spawn is not getting a lot done, and there's no presence on the map from EP. Like, they have no global or anything to go together with the bounty to kill this Phantom Lancer. They don't have anyone more that can like rotate in easily, so it looks like he will go completely unpunished.
It looks like the Bounty Hunter at the moment is just a walking ward. He's giving vision intel to the team, and he is placing some debobs. So in theory, Energy Pacemaker could set up some kills, but oh, it looks like the kill's going to be on mid lane, lifting up Van with the Laguna Blade. Ember Spirit didn't even have a chance to activate his Remnant. down on sidelines for 30 seconds. Glimpse back onto the Rubick with Static Swarm. Gal is going to be put under a lot of pressure, but they rupture up the Gyrocopter and jump onto the Disruptor with the Clockwork. 5400 dropping low. They buy back on the Rubick even. That might be a little bit overambitious. Lay is pulled inside the cogs. The Rupture will bleed him out. Now they find the DK. A little bit over-aggressive for the Phantom Lancer to keep on going for that as Bounty Hunter cleans up the back lines. Very important for the Bounty Hunter to get this, but now that he's tracked up, will also die. And now they track up the Dragon Knight. This could get scary if there was enough HP on the PL, but there isn't.
Nope. Feel getting... being involved in 2 kills there, I think it was. It wasn't there for the first, and... Clockwork going a bit too deep, but Midas running and you trade even is pretty good for Newbie Young.
There was track involved and a buyback from the Rubick. I think that trade is almost dead even.
Yeah. Stolen track as well, that's really good for Rubick. He has it for a long time as well. Which will maybe save this tower, because they're kind of afraid of going when Newbie has vision on them. But I guess they know Phantom Lancer is greedy and did not go back in regen.
Little TP in onto the front lines. That's the Lina, but I think the best they can hope for is a tier 1 tower deny, and they get the Lina glimpse back. Any chances of actually contesting this tower push are completely gone.
That ward was just in range. He stood at the edge of it and the glimpse ensures the tower. I don't think they would have said it either way, but maybe could have gotten a deny out of it.
In general, I really like this ward.
Yeah, it's pretty good actually. It was better than I thought. It really made difference as soon as the trees went down.
Yeah, the common D ward spots for mid lane wards in the middle of the river and over onto the high ground don't catch that vision ward. So yeah, I think it's given them a lot of value this game.
Bounty found. Pops haste though.
Trying to run away, gets hookshotted in. They'll be able to blow him up at the very least. Lei's going to drop the cooldown, catches out two with the Static Storm onto Melody Lovers. But Lei is getting lifted up and brought down by the Bloodseeker. They'll lose their Lina and trade. Now with chains onto two, Iwi and SCC are in a lot of trouble. Clockwork is going to pretty much guarantee his fate, but secure the retreat out by the Bloodseeker, making a 2-for-2 trade across the board.
Yeah, 2-for-2 trade, and Midas is still running. Pretty good for Newbie Young. Clockwork making an okay play there. He sacrificed himself so to ensure that Bloodseeker would got away, taking no risks in because of Midas running on Bloodseeker. He doesn't really want him to die.
Yeah, and that's kind of the undertone this game. The Midas is running there for Newbie Young are going to be a, I don't know, ticking time bomb. Energy Pacemaker haven't appropriately punished them. And after those Midases, you're going to get some pretty major items coming up. Phantom Lancer isn't going to build into a lot of stats, instead going for the Boots of Travel. A very farm-oriented build coming out from him, but in 20 minutes, this Phantom Lancer is going to be almost unmanageable.
Yeah, this is full greed from Phantom Lancer, going Midas and Boots of Travel, really trying to maximize farm. Might get punished now, though. Perfect rotation from EP, or like, perfect timing on it. But it's a pretty hard kill.
They have a missile flying out, but it's just the two supports. They'll drop a call down. Ben Lancer is fairly squishy. They'll track him up, but he has the doppelganger. He should be able to escape. He's going to doppelganger the missile, but glimpse back in. That won't be stopped. They'll shuriken him in. They'll try to manfight up against 5400, but alone, the Phantom Lancer will die. That's an important pickup for Energy Pacemaker.
Yeah, they really needed that kill. If they had let that one go, I think Newbie Young would have gotten so much out of it. Like, if he had escaped there, there was a 4-man rotation in then, even in then Old Chicken comes down as well, but if they had let it go, they would have lost so much of the slight. They're pretty close to Newbie Young so far, even though they're Midas running, but they have to kill these Midases.
Glimpse in mid, Clockwork caught it in the kinetic field, trying for the TP. Will the damage be there? With 3 remnants, it will. 5400 secures himself the kill and a killing spree.
Yeah, Newbie Young a bit too aggressive. They had their jungle, they don't really have to make this place. They can easily just farm their own jungle.
I think they just... well, that's gonna be a...
two supports killing that one. That's the like power of Laguna Blade, the power of Lina.
In general, even from the support role, as long as you have that level 6, Ember Spirit can't survive. He has 3 points in the Flame Guard, and usually that's gonna keep him sustained, but not gonna happen. Oh, inside the river area, Dragonite's ruptured with no TP. Old Chicken might be a little bit of trouble. Remnant forward by Piao, they'll pull him up, lift him away. Phantom Lancer joins the fight, and Old Chicken will go down as Rubick secures it with the Ember Spirit ultimate.
Yeah, 2 deaths from EP, both are cores as well, and that's suddenly the Phantom Lancer kills didn't really matter, because they won't get this bottom tower, and Fanonaz is putting a lot more pressure on their own safe lane tower. And mid tower is gonna go down as well. They are possibly losing two towers here.
This is scary. TP in, coming out from the Ember Spirit. He'll get the chains just the same onto Iwi, but he'll hook shot out to the Bloodseeker. Glimpse back. All that hard work from Iwi is going to be put to naught. He'll get Shuriken, and that's a track kill for three or four heroes coming out from Energy Pacemaker. But all the while, Phantom Lancer's been pushing top, and SS finds himself with enough gold to finish up his Yasuo. It looks like an SNY build coming out from Fio.
Yeah, it's pretty standard. This is like full farm. Yasuo enhances your farm even more. You have more. Your illusions can attack faster, do more damage, also more movement speed, so you can run between camps even faster. But space created for by Cloakwork, even though he gave away a track kill, which is not ideal. They get a tower on top lane for PL, and he can farm enemy jungle as well.
These remnants on the Rubick are doing quite a lot when it comes to helping it go for these kills. They'll catch eyeballs onto the bounty hunters. He tracks up the Lina, and Clockwork comes in, but glimpsed away all the way back home. Iwi, unfortunate. The Disruptor's fountain glimpses this game have been very annoying for newbie young to deal with.
Yeah, this pick has really paid off. Clockwork has kind of has died or not been able to initiate a few times because of Disruptor. And he's being kept on because of it. He hasn't even picked up his blade mail yet, even though he looked pretty good for quite some time.
After the early game, 175, the Clockwork's lost pretty much all semblance of momentum. Bottom lane, the Phantom Lancer in a little bit of trouble. He goes aggressive onto 5400, but there's a Static Storm Kinetic Field waiting with Call Down, as well as the Gyrocopter joining this. The Phantom Lancer should go down here, although they get the Rupture onto Lake. Can Bloodseeker get this by himself with the BKB? He will. TP out by the Disruptor will keep him alive, and the BKB is wearing thin. Stun over onto poor Piao. The Rubick is tracked and has no hope, although with Remnants, one jump, two jump. Maybe I spoke too soon. Nope, Shuriken will bounce towards him. Double kill for Fan. SCC now being chased. That first BKB usage was far from ideal, and now isolated. This is going to be another track kill for Energy Pacemaker. 4-for-1, and all they lost was the support Gyrocopter. That's a big turn of events.
Yeah. Fanon, I think, being way too aggressive there. He should know that he can't kill the Disruptor. First of all, he should know that there's a gimmick cape before he goes. He should check it immediately. And then even going is so greedy there. And Gyro goes from back. That's pretty surprising, but it's a really good pickup, I feel like. They can push their advantage they got because of that, with Dragonite being a really good pusher.
Yeah, I don't think the Gyrocopter needs to transition yet into late game damage. If this game goes like to 70 minutes, then maybe we'll see late transition, but he's not getting that much income. I think the mechanism will help a lot more than going for Helm and trying to turn himself into a farming Gyro 20 minutes in.
Yeah, that was a 4k swing just that fight. That's really big for Energy Pacemakers, and they got an all outed powers. And I don't think they have any items coming up soon. They have the Battle Fury now. So they have maximum potential right now. They have picked up all the core items. They should really go and pressure this now. Only Bounty is close to a 4 staff. That's the only item they maybe should wait for.
Yeah, and even if he doesn't get a single CS, he'll find that in just a couple of seconds. It's not really something that they have to wait for. He'll have that flying out to him in just a little bit. Energy Pacemaker find themselves with a new lease on life. Since the Bloodseeker and Phantom Lancer have committed to these Hands of Midas's, their net worth is artificially inflated when it comes to the chart, and if we take off that 2k, they're the only heroes that are keeping up with the enemy team. The track gold for the Gyrocopter as well as the Disruptor is really making a big difference when you compare their net worth to the Rubick, Clock, and Lina.
Yeah. I wonder if Ember is going to go for something like a boost of travel to
BKB pop down in bottom lane. Old Chicken, I think that was a misclick. He wanted to pop his illusions.
Yeah. This means they might not be able to take the tower. Yeah, they will back off. They're too scared now. They have to rely on the BKB. There's a lot of magic damage with the Lina and also some random spells. It does quite a lot of damage.
That sets Ember. Them back by quite a lot.
Yeah. Ember being so aggressive. I mean, Phantomless being so aggressive on top lane. He went for Sanchez as well. Not going for the Manta. But this is like the safer build. It gives him some survivability. He might have thought about Manta, and then after the death on bottom lane, he really wanted some more HP.
SCC is going to be scouted out by the Bounty Hunter. They'll track up the Bloodseeker, and that's about it. Energy Pacemaker, since they're forced to fall back and farm, the state of the game is favoring newbie Young, as the Phantomancer and Bloodseeker keeping up, and maybe getting a little bit more acceleration than their counterparts on the enemy side. That BKB pop was very unfortunate. The tier 2 tower and bottom lane, all of the tier 2s are looking pretty comfortable. If you take a look at the ward vision coming out from Energy Pacemaker, they're pretty much catered to go for these tier 2 pushes, but for now they can't.
Yeah, Bloodseeker picks up Shadowblade. He's gonna look for the backlines here. He's gonna try and kill Gyro and Disruptor. Disruptor can't do anything if there's some detection on Bloodseeker, but I don't think he has at the moment, at least.
And he doesn't want to get rid of his Quelling Blade to hold on to it, but I think it's probably the right choice.
Yeah, well, I think they know Bont is here, but they're not sure.
The 4-staff away, and Bounty Hunter's home free.
That 4-staff was pretty clutch. I think Rubick was incredibly close to lifting him there.
Over in the sidelines, Dragonite's coming in from the left. They have track on Bloodseeker, and they want to open up with the track movement speed. They might be able to get in range. He's forced to pop a BKB and man fight. Old Chicken will pop his BKB in kind, and with the Blood right on the ground, I'm not sure they want to go in. Rupture it up. The Dragonite needs to hold his own, and he will do so with the stacks from Kinetic Field onto 2. Phantom Lancer will be exploded. The Dragon Slave over 4 is pretty nice, but now Melody Levers is forced to man fight up against Old Chicken and company. With the Glimmer Cape under the Dragonite, he hardly gets tickled by that Lina's burst. 4 unanswered kills. That fight was amazing for Energy Pacemaker. With track thrown in, it honestly doesn't get much better than that.
Yeah, that's over 5k gold swing. That's Clockwork going in there was a big mistake. There was a PKB on Dragonite, and they still go for the hook on him. You can't really kill the Dragonite. The best you can hope for is to isolate the rest of the team and wait for PKB to end, but you don't really want to go into that choke point with a disruptor on the enemy team.
Immediately after the fact, Energy Pacemaker will take a tier 2 tower in the middle lane, and they have bought themselves more time again. The track gold is starting to really pile up. The Gyrocopter has arcane boots on top of his mechanism urn. The Disruptor is working towards what looks to be a 4-staff, but they're getting all of the utility items that they could want this game, and Energy Pacemaker, they have a pretty commanding lead. Getting this Ancient Stack for Ember Spirit also helps quite a lot. It doesn't feel like the Midases have fully transitioned the Phantomancer and Bloodseeker into really potent threats yet.
Yeah, they have good gold net worth, they're both leading, but it doesn't really matter because the Midas are not really doing anything right now. They are losing every fight, and the supports and also Bont are getting so rich because of the track gold. And Clockwork is falling so far behind now. He's a hero that has to keep up with items to an extent if he wanna do stuff.
Yeah, he still can make the initiation in, but immediately after he's going to die, unless you have like a 4-staff or Ags or something along those lines to tank the Clockwork up and give him some sort of escape route. And yeah, unfortunately the Clockwork hasn't been able to find those initiations into these fights, and the game plan for newbie Young is pretty much just wait until Bloodseeker and Phantom Lancer can 2v5. It's not a good situation to be in, but that's kind of the state of the game.
Yeah, the Fuchsia Blade coming up on PL pretty soon, but it's pretty hard for him to use it. There's no heroes that he really can use it on and kill reliably. There's a BKB on Dragonite, and the rest are hard to catch.
Oh, sideline fight, maybe a Bruin as Melody Lovers has been tracked up with the Drum Charge and the Glimpse back. They'll catch out 4 for Lina, and usually that's not a big deal, but that's 4 heroes that are involved with, if I'm not mistaken, a level 2 track. That's 400 gold additional just from the track bonus, and a 744 gold swing for a support kill.
Yeah, it's not really good to feed away those deaths when you're facing a Bounty Hunter. But they only lost one hero, and they could have lost a lot more.
Yeah.
They are probably somewhat satisfied with only losing one, but this probably a tower for EP. I doubt newbie Young will defend. They aren't really ready yet. Phantom Lancer isn't strong enough, and Bloodseeker really needs one item before he can go in.
This is scary. Energy Pacemaker, even though they don't have Aegis, are still going to apply a lot of pressure to the high ground. Rubick tries his best Naga Siren impression, cuts the creep wave a little bit with Fade Bolt and a couple of auto attacks, but he can't clear that up by himself. They won't be able to fully commit, I don't think, but every once in a while just a shot from the poison attack of Dragon Knight, and they'll get this tier 3 tower down to half, I'd guess, at least with this ultimate form from the GK.
Yeah, they're gonna fall back. I guess they don't wanna go ahead in. If they lose one fight here, that can actually mean they just lose the game because they feed away way too much gold to Midas heroes.
And
And
now
Phanom.
Nubion? They smoke up. They want to catch something on the retreat. Not sure if they can, though.
And Clockwork sees them.
Quick shot in. Catches out 5,400. But a glimpse back, and the Clockwork would be way back home. They could just turn around and kill him if they wanted to. Glimmer Cape on 5,400 will keep him sustained. On the sidelines, he's spotted out Mount by the Bloodseeker. He'll get one shot in. The Ember Spirit throws his fist, but Phantom Lancer dives so deep for that Gyrocopter kill that he's isolated. Now Melody Lovers will also lose his head. Shuriken thrown, and SCC is in a lot of trouble. Lift up from Piao will help a little bit, but Dragonite has an Ace Trim. He's not going to stop. Dragontail over onto Bloodseeker with follow-up from Fan. And SCC, that TP attempt was very, very hopeful. The last remaining hero from Radiant Side is Piao. He'll be killed off. A lot of track gold for Energy Pacemaker and all... Or all that Nubian get in return is the Gyrocopter and Disruptor, two supports.
Yeah, Nubian really wanted to punish Old Chicken for not having Elder Dragon form there, but they couldn't afford that for it. Phantom Lancer is not tanky enough to go high ground there into four heroes alone, and they didn't get disrupted fast enough.
Now the tier 3 tower again is under siege. Without the DK form, it's a lot slower push coming out from Energy Pacemaker, and they still probably won't get it, but they're getting so much gold from all these exchanges. They're not even trades for Nubian, really. It's just one fights for Energy Pacemaker, and that transitions into a full Daedalus for your Ember Spirit. Dragonite has a Sanji Asha, BKB, and 2,000 gold on top of all of that, presumably AC next. These are really big ticket items.
Yeah, several fights going in the favor of EP. Nubian were about 4,000 ahead in gold, and now suddenly EP are over 10,000 ahead because of the track. It's looking pretty bad for Nubian, and the Phantom Lancer is not gaining items fast enough anymore. He needs to tank up now, but I think they know he's there.
Kinetic Field not going to catch him out, and the Phantom Lancer will survive a little while longer. He'll go up towards the north, and I think he is not spotted. Will survive, but actually contesting this for Sean is a different story for Nubian. I don't think they can do it, even though they get vision with the flare. Medallion up for the Bounty Hunter means that this is going to fall reliably enough that Energy Pacemaker get themselves a free Aegis.
Yeah, Bounty going full utility here. It's working out though. It's not the most common way to build him, but it's looking really good for him. And this guy is pretty farmed thanks to him being able to track up and things like that. I'm not sure what Gyro will go next. I think they should look to kinda end this game within 10 to 15 minutes.
Yeah, Bounty Hunter, if you take a look at his items, is almost capped out when it comes to his item slots, since he has gone for so many, about 2k cost items, and then the Gyrocopter, even if he'd like to transition, he went for Guardian Griefs, and that's a lot of item commitment so that they can just keep on pushing. I think you're right in saying that they should keep on going aggressive, even though Ember Spirit and Dragonite can, in theory, be very threatening late game. I think just keep on going with this tier 2 tower push would be the course of action, but Nubian also have a bit of a split push going in top lane. With Boots of Travel on the Phantom Lancer, he can come back at any time, and I'm pretty sure that the Clock, as well as the Bloodseeker, are also holding out a TP scrolls. In fact, there's three up for the Bloodseeker. Not going to save their 2-2 tower in bottom lane, and Ember Spirit isn't down in bot yet either, but he has a Revenant, so this could be a 5v5 fight, even though not everybody's in bottom lane yet.
Yeah, I wonder if EP will pressure the advantage. Ember just used Sleight of Fist on Bloodseeker and he lost half his HP with this Daedalus. He's gonna do a ton of damage in these fights now, and Phantom Lancer needs like two more items before he can tank Ember Spirit's damage.
I don't think Phantom Lancer is ever going to get to the point where, relative to the Ember Spirit, he's going to be tanky and can actually survive the Sleight of Fist. It's really brutal.
Yeah, it's gonna be very hard for Phantom Lancer. They need to somehow not have Ember killing them all. I don't know how. I think it has to be Clockwork's job somehow, but he's too underfarmed for that.
Yeah, if Clockwork was sitting on like a Scythe of Ice or something, or there was a Blink Scythe initiation coming out from Nubian, I'm not sure who would get the farm for that, but just any way to jump the Ember before the fight begins. Up in top lane, Old Chicken going to bump into the Phantom Lancer. He stuns one of the illusions and is almost completely drained out of mana. But even so, the Phantom Lancer could be in a little bit of trouble because there is a hasted Dragonite chasing after him. He'll be able to Doppelgang and TP home to safety. If that was daytime, things might have gotten a little bit more interesting, but yeah, with like a 4-staff Shuriken. But Night Team Vision and Fog is going to help the peel.
Yeah. Well, Chicken has gotten like 5 haste this game. Every time I see him doing something, he has a haste. It's hurting Nubian a lot. They got a chase down and lost several heroes.
It makes up for the fact that Old Chicken hasn't gone for like a Shadow Blade or a Blink Dagger to initiate.
Yeah. On Hunter has the Solar Crest. This is pretty good for them because they can siege very well with Dragonite, and Ember can just spam his Light of Fist, and the heroes that are trying to defend it, how will get taken down.
It's a gross amount of armor on Old Chicken. With the Solar Crest activated, he's sitting on like 68% physical resist with evasion and with his base HP regen. He's hardly going to be tickled. They have a Guardian Greaves behind him as well, and just so many ways Energy Pacemaker keep themselves safe. Ember Spirit's pushing down bottom, but this is one of the powers of Ember Spirit. He can just join the fight at any time. Where is this Renamit? It's right in the middle of the lane.
Dragonite going for Mjolnir, not AC. He just want to deal with the Phantom Lancer instead of going for AC. That could have been better, but it doesn't really help Ember. So I think Mjolnir is a really good decision.
Yeah, fair enough. It makes their tower siege damage a little bit less, and with the amount of wave clear that Newbie Young have, it is very difficult to actually get to the front door of the Newbie Young base, and their Aegis isn't going to be lasting for that much longer, only about a minute.
I think he's gonna go for AC afterwards, and I think this item he buys is pretty damn good. It's how you wanna deal with Phantom Lancer late game, because you know, no matter how much flash you have, you kinda want more against Phantom Lancer, because eventually, even heroes like Ember Spirit have a hard time dealing with him. And together with a Dragonite that's disfarmed, you can actually deal with him late game, even though he has Heart and Scott and, or something like that.
Yeah, you have two Battle Furies and a Daedalus up for the Ember Spirit, and he shows no sign of slowing down soon. It's scary. The Midases haven't gotten Newbie Young to the position where they're ahead, but they're probably the only thing that's keeping them in this game. Invisrin on the Phantom Lancer will bail him out, no detection onto him, and he should be completely fine to just TP home to safety.
Bloodseeker and Pillar are keeping up in power quite well. Yeah. It's mainly because of their Midases, but Bloodseeker is getting close to picking up his next item. I'm gonna assume it's AC with Plate Mail. And Clockwork finally got his second item, the 4 staff as well. So they're keeping up somewhat, but that's only because they're not fighting and the track call is not working.
Aegis Reclaim. The window is closing for Energy Pacemaker, and Roshan's not going to be up for 4:30 after that Aegis Reclaim. A bit of a middling timer for the Roshan, but I think that favors Newbie Young. They'll take any amount of time that they can get before their high ground is pushed again.
Phantom Lancer getting his PKP in 100 gold. It's a pretty big pickup. It means that he doesn't die to Disruptor doing something, but there's still so much AoE that you kind of want your illusion stronger, not your main hero stronger.
Yeah, but the BKB is also kind of necessary when you're dealing with the support duo coming out from Energy Pacemaker. The Static Swarm would pretty much be his death if he doesn't have it.
Yeah, he pretty much is forced to go for it, but it's not an item you want to go.
Yeah.
It's just an item you have to go.
For sure. The game's pace has slowed down a bit. Old Chicken has his completed Mjolnir up. The Dragonite is doing so much damage inside these fights. Up until this point, but Ember Spirit really was the star of the show, but the splash damage from the Dragonite ultimate form is going to be very significant.
Yeah, this Dragonite is going to do a ton of damage. I'm not sure what is going to go next. I think AC is a good option. He could also go for Daedalus, which would increase his damage a lot, and he could actually siege very efficiently, but AC does pretty much the same thing. And Rubick is way too aggressive, I think.
Well, the chains are going to be mistimed, but it doesn't matter, they have vision with the track, they'll pull them back in, that's a track kill for 5 heroes, and no Rubick in the next fight. Energy Pacemaker find themselves in a situation where they're 5v4, Rubick drops the gem before going for that, but the gem's picked up by the Gyrocopter just the same. They'll start the siege, and they're just gonna mow through this tier 3 tower as soon as the glyph expires.
Yeah, no buyback on Rubick, and they'll probably take down the tower, I'm not sure if they'll go for more, it's pretty risky. But
they rupture up Old Chicken, but yeah, I think they're going to keep on committing. Rupture doesn't matter, the Dragonite's just stuck in their base, there's no way you can move him.
Yeah, I think this Rupture was a mistake. It's easy for them to push in now. There's no Rupture, so they are not afraid of being chased, so they can easily retreat when they have to.
And a glimpse back, the Radiant team can't retreat even to their own well. Melee barracks after the range are going to fall, a full set for Energy Pacemaker. Without Clockwork, they might be able to go for even more.
Yeah, Dragonite with a blink, I love this item on Dragonite.
Oh, SCC, he's caught out between the entire enemy team. He's gonna open up a delay with a little bit of help from the PL, but oh my god, the Battle Fury cleave! They both die! No buyback on the Phantom Lancer, and they'll get a glimpse onto the Lina. They just can't do anything godlike for Fan. GG called out. That last fight was gross.
Yeah, same. The seems like there's always a point where you reach and one team just dominates completely. It's happened all three games so far.
Commanding lead for the Energy Pacemaker side. It looked a little bit scary there for a moment when the Bloodseeker and Phantom Lancer were getting out of control, but they never became super relevant with their farm, and the fights didn't go their way. A lot of that comes down to the Clockwork not finding good angles of initiation. That was really the missing piece of the puzzle for the newbie young side, and that'll cost them game number one. We're going to game number two shortly. Cynical Anywhere should be on your screen in about 5 minutes. We'll be back. Grandis Feet and Kefka here to bring that game to you in just a minute.